So here further, Kardama Muni is explaining the importance of the ruler, king, Swayambhuva Manu, his important duties in the society which he is carrying out. So here he is saying, Adharmascha Samedheta Loluper Vyankusher Nirbhihi Shayane Tvai Lokoyam. Shayane Tvai Lokoyam means if you lie down for rest, or Prabhupada translates, if you gave up all thought of the world's situation. That means if the king did not think about the situation of his subject, he does not carry out his duties assigned for a king or a kshatriya, then what will happen? Adharmascha samedheta. Adharma, unrighteousness, would flourish. Samedheta means it will become more and more, it will flourish. Why it will flourish? Loluper vyankusher nirbihi. Uncontrolled people who are greedy and hankering simply after money, what they will do? Dasyu grasto vinangshati. They will be like miscreants, and then everything will be perished. So, if you gave up all thoughts of the world situation, unrighteousness would flourish. For men who hanker only after money would be unopposed. Such miscreants would attack and the world would perish. So, such was the important duty of a Kshatriya king, that if he did not perform his duty, where is the question of spiritual culture? Everything will be unprotected. Only who will flourish? Miscreants will flourish. They will attack everybody. They will take away everything. Whole world will perish. So where is the question of either economic development or spiritual life? Everything will be vanquished. So, Prabhupada, in the purport, is explaining something very important in connection with how the civilization today is perishing. Why we are seeing that the whole society has become in a deplorable condition, lamenting condition, same thing. What Kardama Muni is saying is actually happening. Why this is happening? So Prabhupada is analyzing this very nicely. So first Prabhupada is saying, because the scientific division of four varnas and four ashramas is now extinguished, the entire world is being governed by unwanted men. These are these unwanted men. Lolupaihi, greedy after money. You see, miscreants. The whole world is now governed by miscreants, rogues and thieves. Dasyu. These are the words which are used here. Dasyu grasto vinangshati. Why this is happening? Why? Because actually there is no proper division in the society. There is no training for the intellectual class of people. There is no proper training for Kshatriyas, martial class of people. Some Vaishyas, that is some kind of business is going on, but that is also actually not according to the Vedic scriptures. It is more of just making money. Vaishya's business was not that, simply making money. Krishi, Goraksha, so many important things were there. Only excess whatever was there, he would trade. Just like we see in the example of Ananda Maharaj. Not that they were traders like that. Isn't it? We see thousands and thousands of cows and farm, all those things were there. So practically there is no training for all these things. So Prabhupada says specifically three very important things a person has to be trained in. What is it? So these unwanted men, they are not trained in three important things. One is religion, politics and social order. So no understanding about what is varna, what is ashrama. No understanding about dharma, religion. No understanding even about how to govern politics. Nothing is there. Completely untrained people are governing the whole world. So what do? They are themselves like animals, and they keep people like animals. And then we are thinking there should be peace, there should be prosperity in the society. That is not possible. So Prabhupada is saying, therefore, everything is in a very deplorable condition. What used to happen earlier? How this could have been avoided? So Prabhupada is comparing, earlier there was a scientific training given, especially to the three higher classes. There was a training given. Brahmanas were trained in their character, their qualification and their work. Training is for two important things. Of course, gunas are there, but they have to be polished. Now Krishna has divided the whole society according to guna and ashrama, guna and karma. Both are important. Today what is happening, even though, let us say, somebody is having the guna of a brahmana, but if he is doing the work of a Shudra, then it is of no use. Head doing the work of leg. Isn't it? So, guna and karma, in both of them, there used to be training. So, Prabhupada is giving an example. It is just like in today's society, there is requirement of engineers, there is requirement of doctors, there is requirement of some whatever different occupations we are having. Electricians is there, or so many different kinds of occupations are there. So just like there are institutions to train people into engineers, there are an institution to train somebody as doctors, and then he becomes a qualified doctor, somebody becomes a qualified engineer, and then they do the work of engineer or doctor. Similarly, in Vedic society, in Varnashrama system, earlier there used to be a very, very scientific training that certain class of people who are identified with their guna, who are having the guna of a brahmana, they will be trained as brahmana. Some people who were identified to be very courageous, they will be trained as a kshatriyas. Some people will be identified as vaishyas, they will be trained as vaishyas. And then shudras who would carry out the orders of other three classes, who will assist all the other three classes. And that is how the whole society was divided like this. So now, what is happening, Prabhupada is saying, why the Varnashrama is in deplorable conditions, especially even in India if we see also. Because now it is without training. Somebody is claiming just because I am born in Brahmana family, is not even trained, he is claiming I am Brahmana. Somebody is claiming I am a Rajput, I am Kshatriya, and he is not trained even to kill. If he sees blood, he will faint. And he is claiming that I am Rajput. Isn't it? So no training is there. So Prabhupada is saying here, in the institution of four varnas and four ashramas, there are regular training principles for the different classes of men. Just as in the modern age there is necessity for engineers, medical practitioners and electricians, and they are properly trained in different scientific institutions. Similarly, in the former time, the higher social orders, all these three classes especially, were properly trained. Then the question may arise, how were they trained? What was the training given? Now that is very clearly stated in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is actually very, very practical science. So Bhagavad Gita is explaining, this is the characteristic of Brahmana. See, Shamo, Damo, Tapo, Shocham, all these are characteristic of Brahmana. And then all these are the works of a Brahmana. What are the works of a Brahmana? Patan, patan, yajan, yajan, dana, pratigraha. These are the work of a Brahmana. Similarly, what is the characteristic of Kshatriya? Just like one of the characteristics it is given in Bhagavad Gita, he will never run away from the battlefield. Yuddhecha apalayanam. He will never run. So courageous, chivalrous. All these are characteristics of Kshatriyas. And then what is his work? What he should do? That is defined. Characteristic of Vaishya, and what is his work? Krishi, Go, Raksha, Vanijyam. These are the works of a Vaishya. Then Shudra, one who is not able to take any responsibility. What is his characteristic? All those things are defined. So actually, what training should be given, all those things are very clearly defined in Vedic scriptures. Prabhupada gives an example about this training. Prabhupada says, let us say for example, we have established our community, farm community. So we see in West Virginia there is a huge farm community, thousands of acres of land. So Prabhupada wanted that the whole community, the center should be a temple. Krishna should be the center. Then he wanted that all the devotees who are there in Krishna consciousness, they should all perform varieties of different activities. So then somebody asked this question to Prabhupada. But Prabhupada, devotees are supposed to be transcendentalists. Why devotees have to perform, somebody has to perform the work of a Shudra, somebody has to perform the work of Kshatriyas or something like that. So then Prabhupada gave an example. Prabhupada said that actually, no doubt, there is no such division among the devotees. Then Prabhupada gave an example. He said, just like there are two players, they go and they perform a drama. One takes the role of a king, one takes the role of a queen. Now neither of them are king and queen. They're only performing the role of king and queen. Similarly, Prabhupada gives another example. Lord Krishna himself personally set the example. Sometimes he acted as Kshatriya, sometimes he acted as Vaishya. So does it mean that his position as the Supreme Lord is lost? Just because he acted as a Kshatriya or he acted as a Vaishya? Similarly, it is not that our position as a devotee is lost. If some devotees are assigned the work of toilet cleaning, it's actually work of a Shudra. Toilet cleaning is not work of a Brahmana. It is a work of a Shudra. But a devotee is ready to clean the toilet. You see? So Prabhupada, he wanted that in that farm community, a proper prototype example of how a society should be divided according to guna and karma, we should establish. And then it is possible, and then he wanted there should be Varnashrama college in every center. Wherever we have our temple, there should be a Varnashrama college. First, we divide ourselves among the devotees to set an example for the people, and then we teach to people also how the society should be divided. You see? So, this is important to understand. Just like actually we see this happening even in our small center itself. Right? Now, somebody may be Brahmana, initiated as Brahmana, but then we find Brahmana is also cleaning the temple hall. Isn't it? Somebody may be Brahmana, but he may be a manager also. Actually, the work of Brahmana should be only patan, patan, yajan, yajan, dana, pratigraha. Correct? But for Krishna's sake, whatever is required, the devotee should be ready to do. That is the whole example. So this is called as Devi Varnashrama. That whatever is required to be carried out, so it is not that the now devotee has become a Shudra. That is not the idea. But we have to set this important example for people. And Prabhupada says that actually in Vedic society, everybody had a respectable position. Even Shudra had a respectable position. Today it is completely different. Today the Brahmanas are thinking we are superior. It is not like that. Everybody was considered to be respectable. So Prabhupada gives an example. Just like in the Brahmana, we find to be a respectable position. Similarly, in Kshatriyas, let us say they were called as Thakur. In Vaishyas, they'll be called by certain designation like Mahajana. In Shudras, they'll be called Chaudhari. They'll also be like leaders. Chaudhari is also like a leader. So Prabhupada says there was no such discrimination. Isn't it? Even though, no doubt about it, relatively, like in our body, head is considered to be very important. But does it mean leg is not important? Suppose you get some problem in your leg, will you not spend money for your leg? Will you say, no, it is leg only? No. Very scientific division used to be there. Very proper understanding. Another very beautiful example Prabhupada gives. When he is talking about this Varnashrama, he gives a very interesting example. And similarly Prabhupada says, in our society also, we should follow this understanding. What is the understanding? Prabhupada says, in his time, there used to be a slogan by railways. Railway had made one slogan. All employees of railway should see that the wheel of the rail is always moving. Now somebody may think, I am a clerk, what I have got to see that wheel of the rail is moving or not? I am sitting inside my office, I am working inside, what I have got to do to see whether the railway wheel is moving or not? He may think like this. Prabhupada says, no. Even he has an important role. He has an important role. What is his important role? If he does not do his, if he is not doing his duty properly, there is possibility that there will be traffic jam. If he does not send the, let us say he does not send which train has arrived, which train is going to arrive next. If he does not do his, desk work, there is a possibility the train will not move. So even he has a responsibility to see that the wheel of the rail is always moving. So similarly, Prabhupada said, one should not think in Krishna consciousness, preaching means only giving lectures is preaching. No. Prabhupada is saying, you are all assisting me in printing the books, that is also preaching. Suppose, if there was no BBT and these managers would not see to it properly that properly the book is made nicely, where is the preaching existing? Without books, where is the foundation? Just like sometimes in the very beginning when they brought the book, when Prabhupada just held the book, it fell apart into many pages. And Prabhupada nicely chastised them that you have to see to it that properly this work is done. Isn't it? Somebody is, let us say, not cooking prasadam, everybody is only preaching, then what we are going to eat? What preacher is going to speak if he has no prasadam? So does it mean he is not preaching? Somebody has to clean the temple. If the temple is not clean, nothing is there, nobody will even step inside the temple. So that is not preaching. If we don't construct a beautiful temple and hundreds of people will not come, so temple construction is also preaching, Prabhupada says. So that means this is whole as a preaching movement. And everybody, when they do their proper work and they are trained in their assigned duties, that is very important. Not that everybody has to sit on Vyasasana and has to give class, then only I am a preacher. That is not the idea. That is what we should understand. Somebody will bring money, somebody has to do some kind of business which is required for Krishna. Somebody has to bring donation, go and meet people and bring donation from people. Somebody has to go and sell out books for people. So all these things has to be understood very, very properly. Otherwise we will think until I become president or vice president or something like that, no success. No, Krishna never says like that. Anybody, whoever, that is what the Vedic society was. Wherever they are placed, if by their work they are assisting in the mission of the Lord, then they are successful. That is the whole meaning. Otherwise, why Krishna is saying, Striya, Vesha, Api, Shudra, Te Api, Yanti, Param, Gatim? Anybody. It may be. Anyone who takes shelter of the Lord, if the Lord is the center of their work, then everybody will get success in their life. Just by cleansing the temple of the Lord nicely, so that Prabhupada movement can go on nicely, one will attain perfect success in Krishna consciousness. One should understand this. So just like here we are seeing that there used to be proper training for all different varnas. Similarly, in Krishna consciousness, we have to apply this principle. And we have training for different departments are there. And we should try to perfect our work properly. And if we do that, we are successful in Krishna consciousness. One should understand. If somebody is doing the assistant pujari work, then he should see to it that it is sparkling clean. Then that is perfect work he has done in Krishna consciousness. So, this is the meaning of understanding how properly everyone has to be trained in Krishna consciousness with Krishna as the center. So, one example Prabhupada gave about that farm community. So then devotees were asking, so how do we divide people? So Prabhupada said, yes, you should do one thing. Thousands of acres of land is there. Then according to their different gunas, you give them land. Somebody can be a potter. These are called subcategories. Suppose in Shudra, there may be different categories. Craftsmanship is the work of a Shudra. Okay. Some other people, you can give them land. They can do, you know, agriculture there. And then they should also grow flower for the temple. So, not only he should do the agriculture, whatever flowers he is getting there, without any charges, he should donate it to the temple. Now, Prabhupada then gave the example that in Jagannath Puri, so much of bhoga is offered to the Lord. How it is offered? It is offered in earthen pots. And earthen pots, they are utilized once, after that they are muchi, they are thrown away. Prabhupada says, similarly, these base metals like steel and all, actually they should be thrown away. But what to do otherwise? Today it is not possible. Isn't it? They never used to eat in the same plate again. That was earlier system. But that may not be possible today. So then Prabhupada is saying, somebody is a potter, okay, you manufacture pots for your requirement and you can trade in it. But then, for the temple you should give free of cost, because temple has given you the land. You see? And then similarly, land should be given to even some people who are very courageous. So then they asked, what should be the work of Kshatriyas in our Krishna consciousness? And Prabhupada said, two works should be there, administration, and they should be ready to fight also. Because sometimes there will be problems, some dacoits will come, somebody will try to attack us. They should be ready to fight. You see? And they should administer and see everything is going on nicely. Everybody is engaged in their work properly. So then Prabhupada asked this question. Then they asked question. So Prabhupada, who will take this work of a potter? Who will take this work of somebody has to sweep also, sweeper. They have to sweep the whole streets. Who will take the work? So Prabhupada said, those who come and who are simply eating and sleeping. They should be given that work. You see? Actually, that is the whole idea. Because Shudra means how to identify those who do not want to take any responsibility. They simply want to eat and sleep. They should be engaged. So Prabhupada said, why they should be engaged? Otherwise, idle mind is devil's workshop. If they are not engaged properly, they will. And what is that idle, Prabhupada says, what is that devil workshop? They will only think about money and women. And Prabhupada, that's why he was very strict. He was saying that that is what is happening today. Instead of making proper devotees, there are so many sahajiyas coming out in the name of saying that I am a devotee, putting tilak, kanti mala. He's only some making show of chanting. Only work is eat and sleep nicely. Lazy. That should not be allowed. So Prabhupada wanted this. That even in that farm communities, there should be people who should be engaged like that. And if they are doing their work properly, just by sweeping the street, just by making the pots, just by making a good garden and offering the results to the Lord, all of them will be devotees. We see that example even in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life. There was Kolavichcha Sridhar, right? What was he doing? He was selling banana donnas, you know, made up of that banana leaves. But he was a great devotee of the Lord. So there is nothing like that. In the Vedic system, there was no such discrimination. That potter cannot be a great devotee of the Lord. No. Anybody, anyone whose center is Krishna, they just have to do their work properly as assigned as they are trained. Then everything will flourish. Everybody will be progressive in their march toward back to Godhead. Whether it is Shudras, whether it is Vaishyas, whether it is Kshatriyas or Brahmanas. So very simple. Just like actually even in our Krishna consciousness, that is what we are doing. Everybody may not be able to preach, does not matter. Does it mean that he cannot become a devotee? So some devotee may have to do some cleaning work, somebody has to do assistant pujari work, somebody has to do DT work, isn't it? All these different kinds of works are there, even in our Krishna consciousness we see. But does it mean that somebody's thought, oh, I am a preacher so I am great, I am sannyasi, I am great? No, nothing like that. Prabhupada said even sannyasi, sometimes he has to be engaged in managerial work. Actually sannyasi is not required to be engaged in managerial work. So there is no such division, there is no such... This has come now. As Prabhupada is saying, even in earlier society, everybody had their important designations. It is now, it is thought, I am Brahmana, he is Shudra, he is untouchable. All those things are there. These exploitations have started now. Why? Because nobody is trained. So that is what Prabhupada is saying. When there is no such training, one simply claims that because he is born in a Brahmana or Kshatriya family, he is therefore a Brahmana or Kshatriya, even though he performed the duties of a Shudra. Such undue claims to being a higher caste man makes the system of scientific social order into a caste system, completely degrading the original system. Thus, society is now in chaos. Our Indian society is in chaos because of this. All other places the society is in chaos because they don't have even divisions at all. They want to make everybody into one. Isn't it? Actually that is all artificial, that is not possible. Communism means they want to make everybody equal, artificially. Equal is an understanding that everybody has their own strength, they should be trained in their proper strength, and everybody works for a common cause. That is what is missing. So, this is what is very, very importantly said here. And Prabhupada is stressing a lot about the training, which is very important. So just like even in our Krishna consciousness, we should understand that we should be trained to be a Brahmana. We also should not become like these caste Brahmanas. Otherwise it will also happen like that, isn't it? They are also claiming just by thread, I am born in Brahmana family, I am a Brahmana. So similarly we will also say, because I got thread now, I am also Brahmana. Isn't it? Brahmana means then we should also see whether I am actually acquiring the qualities of Brahmana or not. Where Shama, Dhamma, Tapas, Shocham, all those things are there or not. We should also see. Otherwise they started one kind of hereditary system, we will start another kind of system. Where we are also not qualified, no qualification, and we are also claiming I am Brahmana. That should not happen. Prabhupada never wanted this. So if you are initiated as Brahmana, then you must act like Brahmana. Should have qualities of a Brahmana. You should see that you cultivate. And everything is possible by training. It's all by cultivation. Isn't it? So we should understand that by Prabhupada's mercy, actually, we were nowhere. Where Brahmana, everybody is Shudra in Kali Yuga, practically. Kalo Shudra Sambhavat. Prabhupada has given us a very good opportunity to be trained in Krishna consciousness, in varieties of different position. So we should not take it for granted. We should have proper achar. Then there is possibility of prachar. Otherwise it will be only show bottle. So in one of the classes earlier we were hearing that Prabhupada personally says two important things the devotees, when they do, he is very much pleased. Anybody remembers? Few days back we were hearing in one of the classes, spiritual master, because we know the only way to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead is yasya prasada bhagavat prasado, yasya aprasada na gati kutopi. If the spiritual master is not pleased, there is no possibility of pleasing the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, spiritual master has given us some important principles, some guidance, certain training. And if we follow all of the instructions of the spiritual master, he is very much pleased. If we develop ourselves in Krishna consciousness, the spiritual master becomes very pleased by seeing his disciple is advancing in spiritual life. The spiritual master becomes very pleased. If he is very obedient, Prabhupada was saying, a few days back also we were hearing, right? Even normal man, he becomes very pleased if somebody is very obedient. So spiritual master becomes specially pleased. Shushrusha manaha, one who is obediently rendering service. So that is one. And another is, once we have acquired these qualities, we should try to preach. These two things should go on parallelly. Then the spiritual master becomes very pleased. But without ourselves getting trained in these important qualities, it will not be very effective when we preach to people. See, that is what we should understand. So we'll stop with this Granthra. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai.